misconception. Misconception. Misconception.
I'll leave your brain stimulated.
Slang came from a land where they suffer from the effects of depravity, like gang banging and earthquakes. Most famous, no name, a split a brain and plain a taste for the king of kings. I know it's a strange concept, peddling redemption, boy, what more can I say? Made me in like craving, trying to make him famous, it's an entree. Filling these 58s with phrases that would deem us unfit to succeed among these heathens. It's so crucial in the belly of the crucible that you would understand that stage like him on a canyon. It's handing out cancer, that's why fame was never the aim. In the back is the front, on my left side up, that's a concept.
Misconception. Misconception.
So many misconceptions, missing a mark, misdirected, driving wreck. Listen aggressive, fueled by our false perceptions. Our methods need corrections, spitting venom in the face and violate the ones we should protect. It's an attempt to motivate, neglect our obligations. Place the blame on someone else, point out the flaws in other people and take the focus off ourselves. Those who have been abused view leadership as illegitimate, so they don't think it's necessary to play by the rules or submit. They see authority as nothing more than a power trip, and they don't want to be plugged into it. They'd rather see that power strip, get it, power strip. It's unfortunate, disproportionate. The door is wide open for false teachers to twist the truth and distort it. No examples left to follow, left to automize. Acting foolish but can't see it, so we're wise in our own eyes. The life and crucifixion of Christ is a beautiful depiction of service and submission within a leadership position.
Misconception.
Oi, Bill, say hi.
Misconception.
You probably have it all figured out, right? Like you're the type that believes that if you act right, then that just might make you righteous in God's sight. You've been a really good person, you followed the good book as much as you could. You probably didn't go to church as much as you should, but it's all good. I mean, you never really killed anybody, never really steal from anybody. You never lusted much, shedded much touching of any bodies. You never use the Lord's name in vain, and you respect your neighbor. You try to maintain peace, love your enemies, and not hold on to anger. You really believe that you could receive God's favor by your good deeds and right behavior. But you're dead in your transgressions and need a savior. Cause you can never win God's approval or the removal of simple discretion. Your righteous acts of removing God's wrath is in fact the biggest misconception.
Misconception. Misconception.
Since my conception, I've been riddled with deception. Televised lies devised to lead a blind insurrection against the resurrection and the greatest misconception. The world believes the Christian is foolish without direction, and they knock it, then knock it. But what does it profit a prophet to be socially ostracized? And no, we ain't stopping to mock it. But if there's anything I can do to raise the stock in the market for a biblical worldview, then there's no longer an option. Here with the humble beast and no subtleties and no tongue-in-cheek, this is what I mean. They don't understand anything about the faith I believe in. They want to belittle me, but it's cool though. They just know the pseudo, the fake faith, the false one, the Western God is man-made, and not the biblical awesome. Toss them, pick up the reasons for God by Timothy Keller and read it. There is a God you should believe in, and his name is Jesus.
Misconception.